Today, the USA tops the list of countries with the highest number of registered invasive species. According to recent research, by 2022, over 6,500 invasive species had been recorded in the United States alone. Their numbers are on the rise and it's happening fast. The economic damage from invasive species and the expenses incurred in controlling them in the U.S. are estimated at $120 billion annually. And Florida tops the charts for the most invasive species. Florida has more non-native reptiles and amphibians than anywhere else in the world, with one local biologist estimating that 26% of all species in the state aren't originally from there. In our episode today, we will talk about the most invasive species that the U.S. begs to kill. Let's dive in. Peacocks aren't native to South Florida. They come from Sri Lanka, other parts of Asia, and even Africa. Yet these birds freely roam some areas of Florida and are pretty common sights. They just live. Additionally, for about 20 years, efforts have been made to protect birds from killing or trapping in South Florida. Why? There was no practical benefit from peacocks. People simply like beautiful birds. It's like peacocks add charm to the places where people live. It's easy to guess what happened next. Peacocks started breeding like crazy. Over the past decade, the peacock population has skyrocketed by at least 10 times. In some areas, there are already hundreds of them. When you have a bunch of these birds in your area, they take up a lot of space, get really aggressive, and fiercely defend their turf. Peacocks are convinced that humans are a threat to their nests, so they feel the need to attack. Plus, peacocks attack their reflection in car doors or windows because they think they're seeing a rival. This leads to scratches, beak marks, and upset car owners. So finally, the government started dealing with those beautiful birds as invasive species. The simplest and most obvious idea was to make males sterile through vasectomy. Scientists found that by doing this, they can prevent the breeding potential of up to 10 females, because males are polygamous. Our next guest isn't a mundane invasive species, but it can wipe out entire ecosystems in the USA. Allow me to introduce you to apple snails. Since apple snails are invasive, the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission is literally asking people to crush the egg clusters and toss them into the water. You might have come across these short videos, so that's why people crush them. Female snails lay eggs about once a week, so they quickly take over new territories. They're also incredibly voracious. They eat just about anything they come across. Even predators suffer from apple snails, not just their usual prey. Nearly any creature that dares to eat these snail eggs will get poisoned. These clusters look unmistakably like bright pink bunches of eggs, making them hard to miss. You can also crush or freeze adult snails, but the important thing is to avoid touching the eggs with bare skin, and especially not touch your eyes after handling these little balls. The snail egg cluster contains a toxin that can cause a rash. Apple snails were first brought to Asia, specifically Taiwan, from Argentina, between 1979 and 1981, with the idea of using them as potential food sources. Gradually, these snails made their way to Hawaii, and from there to the mainland. Today, these snails can already be found in several states across the U.S., like Florida, Georgia, Texas, and Louisiana, and they keep spreading. In October 2023, they even made their way to North Carolina. In Florida, USA, no one raised the alarm when a couple of pet iguanas got loose. Nobody paid much attention because iguanas can't handle the cold, so it seemed like they'd just freeze and that'd be that. Problem solved. But people seriously underestimated the creature. Sure, iguanas don't dig the cold because they're cold-blooded, but that hasn't stopped them from spreading all over the southern part of the state. Actually, frozen iguanas are quite amusing. When the temperature drops below 45 degrees Fahrenheit, they go into a sort of cold-induced stupor. It's their way of protecting themselves until it warms up to at least 50 degrees. They're still breathing and their essential functions are still running, but they can't hold on to branches. So these frozen iguanas, who prefer to sleep up high, just fall onto roads, cars, and on the heads of unsuspecting pedestrians. Each female iguana can lay 70 eggs a year. The current total population of all species of iguanas in Florida is estimated to be over several hundred thousand, and it seems like their invasion can't be stopped. NBC's 6 South Florida TV station ranked iguanas among the top 3 scariest invasive species in Florida. Residents and government officials blame iguanas for wrecking gardens, damaging canals, and pushing out native species that originally inhabited Florida. Lizards also cause damage to plants and residential and commercial landscapes. What do you think the American government should do to get rid of all these invasive animals? Tell me your thoughts below in the comments. And don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed our video. See you very soon with a new episode.